The battle line has been drawn. The Kampala Capital City Authority Lord Mayor Erias Lukwago has announced.
We are also going to use these 45 days effectively to mobilize the people of Kampala to reject this bill. I'm sure they will not find us wanting in fighting this battle. So it's a battle they have declared, they have drawn the battle line. That's one thing. And we are prepared to go that route. So we are going to fight this bill legally and politically. One, we are going to mobilize the people of Kampala to reject it, as I've said. Two, if need arises, we may seek for redress, court redress, which of necessity will involve filing a petition in the Constitutional Court.
Lukwago's renewed fight against government follows the tabling of a KCC amendment bill in Parliament on Tuesday that will make the Lord Mayor elected by the Council from among the Lord Councillors.
Let's get a mechanism of resolving governance issues in KCCA.
The former minister in charge of KCCA, now Minister for ICT and Information, Frank Mebaze, laid ground for the bill in 2015, which has now found its way back in Parliament.
Get Lukwago out of State Hall. That's Mr. Museveni's main preoccupation now.
If passed by Parliament and assented to by the President, the executive powers of the Lord Mayor as a political head will now be given to the minister.
Current form vests powers to govern Kampala in the authority presided over by the Lord Mayor. This has been the crux of the matter. The center of controversy stems from there.
The opposition lawmakers in Parliament have joined Lukwago to oppose the proposed bill.
There is a snake in the State House, and whoever goes there is beaten by that snake. Now, when I see the evils he's beginning to do against the people of Kampala, I can begin to suspect that she's one of the four that have been beaten by the very snake she's talk about that is in State House.
Whatever maneuvers some elements in government are trying to bring is to really disenfranchise the Ugandans of their power. The voters in Kampala are not complaining. They're not saying the way they have been using to choose the mayor is problematic. So in whose interest is anybody bringing a new law?
You cannot deny the people of Kampala the right to vote their leader. If they are doing so, then it's very cumbersome, it's very bad for this state. One day President Museveni will not be here. One day Erias Lukwago will not be there. But the post of the Lord Mayor of Kampala is going to stay there.
If you go to the extent of limiting them in deciding who should be their leader, then you will see what will happen. Don't cause chaos in Kampala. Don't cause chaos in Uganda.
I just want to advise the government and the ministers concerned to shelve this bill. Otherwise, they are going to be humiliated on the floor of Parliament.
The challenge, however, is the current Parliament. Majority of them belong to the ruling party NRM that is pushing for the amendments to take effect. Jingo Francis, NTV.